Hello, welcome again to this.
I'm Lord.
I don't have any planned speech for this video. I don't know how I'm gonna go about telling all of this, because from your perspective, this might seem really bizarre. But, okay, I'm just gonna see how I'm gonna say this. So, about over a year ago, we started contemplating how we have 9 people in games on this, and everybody can be active. It's very difficult to manage 9 people at the end of the day. And we all have different time zones, we all have different schedules, things we do daily. And since we're all growing up, we have more things to do, we're busier and everything. So it started to become very difficult to keep track of everybody and to have everyone equally in videos, as you probably have noticed if you've had your eyes open, that most videos lately have been just me, Viper Rippy, Polly. So while I say that, there's still other people than that. But that's been mostly just the four of us, because we're all basically in the same times we hang out, and we have a lot of free time in our hands, as far as I can tell. So that's how the videos have been going for the past at least a year. And Blaine and Pierce have been there too. Pierce not as much lately, but still. So I'm pretty sure I know already what the title of this video is, so I think I should just get to it. What I did last night, I talked to Phasius, Quinny, and Waffles, and I had to explain to all of them that I was going to let them go, and that this is probably for the best of all of us, and that we can't keep going with the group like this. It's not the way things should go. And it's been a really long time coming, really long time. This would have happened way earlier already if I was, I don't know how to put it. I've been dreading this whole situation for a really long time. I've been dreading the conversations where I tell them. I've been like going through them in my head, like explaining, like thinking what I'm gonna say. I didn't find anything specific to say. It was a really weird situation overall, and I had to do it separately 3 times, of course. And it was really tough. But we all felt like it was something that needed to be done. Yeah, because while I say that the group dynamic is important, it might be a different in how you see it. And when I say that, because I say the group dynamic is important, but at the same time, a lot of the group members never are there, and it's just 4 of us, but there are 9 of us on the group, so how could I find it that important? Well, I think the friendship between all of us has been, to all of us, the most important part this whole time. Gamesoness has been a strange growing up experience and learning experience for, I think, all of us, most of us. And while we do videos every day, and even though most of them don't get a lot of views, you might wonder what's really driving us. I've at least always considered the videos to be a very fun thing to do, and it's been a really great bonding experience with all my friends. And because of all this was a really difficult situation to face. And yeah, jeez. But now, I returned from the army some time ago. So now, what I'm looking at, I'm not gonna go into much detail. I'm not exactly in that place where I want to tell you a million personal details about myself. But now I'm in a place where I have a lot of free time in my hands for the moment. So the channel at least is gonna flourish in the next, or I would say 2015. I'm not gonna say next week's, 2015. My aim is to do my hardest. I'll try my best, see what actually comes up the channel, because we have scary Gmon maps. That's the thing that started it all. But at the end of the day, scary Gmon maps is still very, you know, cheap jump scare horror stuff that we do. I enjoy recording it. It's obvious people enjoy watching it. The content's very niche, because there's not a lot of scary Gmon map is a very bizarre category of things to find. So because of that, it's been very hard to try to keep everyone interested and try to convince people that we do actually try to make other videos. And we aren't just making normal Let's Plays anymore, where we play a game and talk. We've done a lot of that in our time here, but now we're trying to do other things. We're trying to somehow use our creativity. I don't think I'm a creative person, but like, there's something coming out of my weird dumb head. We're trying to somehow make something creative with kind of this other form of Let's Play, this strange form that we've created now, kind of like how Day Offs were, that they were edited, put together in a specific order for you to watch from an hour of gameplay, and it turned into that. But now, well, you're probably gonna see the challenge. If you haven't watched that, that's a video we did, or that's a series that we are doing right now, which is another example of trying to do something different. And we're gonna be trying to do stuff like that, trying to just do something, trying to figure out what we can do that people could be interested in for this year. And I'm gonna do my best to pursue that. Well, I wasn't meaning for this video to have so many things in it. This was mainly just gonna be a video informing you that the game zone is now 6 minus 3. We're now at 6. 6 minus 3, no, 9 minus 6. 9, what? I cannot count. Help me, math. 9 minus 3 is 6. There we go. Good thing I passed first grade. Alright. I don't have a script for this, so I don't know what I would say. But yeah, we are trying to keep the dynamic now together. Now that we have 6, it's easier to manage. We have now that it's a way easier number, at least from my perspective, to try to manage. And basically that just means that there's gonna actually be the members of Games in the videos. And this doesn't, by the way, I like to point out, this doesn't mean that there are now 3 open slots for people to join in. 9 wasn't an ideal number at any point. I don't know if you know this, but the way I went about adding people to Gamesness wasn't this elaborate decision based on some sort of weird social architecture. But it was rather just like, you seem cool, you wanna be in this thing? And surprisingly, for the most part, it worked out. I think this group is full of amazing people, and that's crazy. Considering I really handpick people just for no reason. And the group was always full of amazing people. Waffle Spaces, Quinny aren't excluded from that in any way. But schedules are schedules, and your life's your life. That's just what happened. So I'm not very used to getting real, you might notice, in these videos. I've done maybe a couple of videos where we're actually talking about stuff. There are a few random Let's Play videos where we almost get real, but they're kind of lost and you probably didn't even notice that happened, most likely. But I feel like, even though, like, I think 12,000 subscribers is a crazy amount. I never expected we would even get there. Despite how many subscribers some other people have. It's still an insane number. I never thought we could reach something like that. And I've always felt that I don't think I've exactly kept the fan base and us connected that well. Like, you might know that we play dumb games and that, you know, I'm from Finland, woo, and stuff like that. But I don't think I've ever shared stuff with you guys about myself. And I feel like if we're gonna do this, we should have some sort of connection together. So maybe I'll try to somehow also do that in the future. I'm somehow trying to, you know, I might want to get to know you guys better. I've always found fan interaction to be an important thing. I've close to 150 people, 150 fans on Steam, and try to get to know them a bit, try to get to know our fan base. But that's still small scale compared to how many people actually watch these videos. And it's really interesting to me to find out what you guys are like. I don't think I've ever actually established how important I find that. But I think in the future, maybe this year, we could get to actually know each other. How does that sound? Doesn't sound creepy, right? I'm not actually asking for you to give me pictures of you when you were a child. Because that's illegal, first of all. And I don't know where I'm going with this. But yeah. Gamesiness has been a very interesting experience, considering we all started this when I was 16. I don't know how old you guys think I am. That's how little we really know each other, you and I. But I am 19 years old right now. I'm not... My voice might fool you a bit, but I'm not a responsible adult who understands things. Don't try to think that. We started this when we were 16, which is amazing that we even got successful. Starting so young, not even knowing who you are, what you want to do. But since we evolve as human beings all the time, I think the channel will too, and it'll become different things. I have no plans on stopping this at any point. I never considered that when I get to this age, that's when I'll do other things. I always feel that the channel can be a very easygoing thing. However, since we constantly have huge skips, like 5 days without videos or 2 weeks without videos, it's not been... We haven't been keeping you on the the track all the time. But I'm pretty sure this channel will keep going for a crazy amount of time. I can't imagine it stopping anywhere soon. And we're gonna do our best to try to expand on YouTube. And just in general, I don't know what that means. But we're gonna try to expand on YouTube. We're gonna try to do our best. And hopefully you guys can help us with that. Just in general, you know, share the videos and likes and watch down the favorites. I've never wanted to ask for subscribers. You might notice that if you look at our outro slates, they might say like, they might say favorite, they never said subscribe. And I don't think it really matters, but I've always found it like silly to ask for that, silly to ask for subscribers. I've always thought that if me saying you should subscribe makes you subscribe, then I don't think you should subscribe. I think if you understand that our channel is some content worth watching, then you can do that by yourself. And I think it's important that we understand the numbers perfectly, because even though right now we have 12,000 subscribers, not even 90% of that is people who watch us anymore. They either don't even use YouTube, they're hoping that we release another Scare Gmon map or something like that. But yeah, the numbers are very skewed, and if I was asking for subscribers, I would be, this would be a very different, like, we who knows, maybe if I asked for subscribers, we'd have 20,000 subscribers, but it, what would it really matter? I think, like, honesty, even in this part, is the best policy. So, I don't know what I'm saying. Am I saying you should unsubscribe? Well, that's a horrible way to phrase it. But yeah, this is becoming a weird life vlog right now. But whatever, it's a good start, right? It's not, oh, Rhea, it's not a vlog. I forgot, it's a, well, voice log, right? Vlog, sure. I knew that all along. I wasn't mistaken at all. I might even do an actual video log at some point. Who knows? Then you'll get to realize the horrible disappointment that I'm not Fabio. I'm only almost Fabio. No. But yeah, that's that. Basically, the core of this video is Fezzius, Quinny, Waffles have departed. I'm making it sound like they're dead, by the way. We're not erasing them from our lives in any way. They're not going anywhere. But for the part of this channel, they're not gonna be around anymore. So yeah, games on S, 6 players, bad jokes, stuff. Goodbye.